students, have you ever tried to observe different organisms in your surroundings? Let's do a small activity. Make a list of living organisms from your surroundings. Also note their dwelling places. Is your list done? What is your observation? I'm sure that you must have observed and noted many living things in the list. For example, dogs, cats, lizards, birds, insects, earthworms, and so on. A long list of animals. Among plants, grass, common herbs like tulsi, rose, trees like coconut, mango, neem, etc. You will also find plants and animals growing in water bodies nearby. You must have realized that these organisms are different from each other in many ways. Some are small, some are big, some fly, some of them creep and crawl, etc. Such a great variety exists among them. We have just listed organisms from surroundings. Now, let's try to observe organisms from different climates like desert, mountains, snowy regions, etc. You will find that they also show a lot of variety. Now the question is, why do living organisms from different areas are different? Can you think of the answer? It is because climate is different in different regions. Let's consider following example. How is the climate in desert of Rajasthan? Do you know? The climate here in Rajasthan is mostly dry, hot with very less rainfall. In the contrast, have you visited states like Himachal Pradesh, Kashmir? How is the climate there? In Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh, mostly climate is cold. There is good rainfall. Have you ever seen an animal like camel or plant like cactus in Kashmir? The answer is no. It means plants and animals from one climate may not survive in the different climate. Why is it so? This is because of lack of adaptation. What is adaptation? Adaptation means suitable changes in structure and function of parts to match with particular climate or environment. These changes have taken place very slowly and gradually in millions of years during evolution. Do you know the name of bird called Siberian crane? These birds are normally found near North Pole where there is very cold climate. But these birds fly to the south direction in the month of November, December every year. This migration of birds saves them from harsh winter of North Pole. This is a change in the behavior of organisms to survive. Thus, all living organisms adapt to their surroundings and manage to survive. Now a challenge for you. Human beings live all over the world. How do humans survive in different climates? Summary. So students, you must have realized that climate differs in different parts of the world. Hence, organisms must try to adapt to survive in that climate. It means that we cannot find all organisms everywhere on Earth.